So we got a great show for you tonight.
First of all,
Disney galore.
Oh my God, I know.
What trailers are gonna be now a part of your world?
And also, what is Lea Michele up to tonight?
I don't know, Kelsey. But you know what is gonna happen? We're gonna make Kent feel like Hollywood because this is the Blurb. Thank you for tuning in tonight. We have a lot in store for you this episode, and we'll actually be starting out with a sequel that many fans have been waiting for. So Kelsey, what movie is that?
All right, Shane. After 15 years of waiting, Amy Adams and Patrick Dempsey are back together on screen. The pair brings a sequel to the 2007 live-action and animated film, Enchanted. So excited for this. The official trailer was released over the weekend, leaving Disney fans excited about what's to come when Disenchanted hits Disney Plus this Thanksgiving.
I cannot wait.
So excited.
For that. Enchanted was my favorite movie when I was younger.
Mine too.
But singer-songwriter Louis Capaldi spoke out about being diagnosed with Tourette's syndrome. So for the Before You Go singer, the diagnosis was something he knew little about, but answered a lot of questions for him. So in an Instagram video, Capaldi shared what the experience is like along with the outpour of support. Capaldi's charisma still radiates when people suggested him as an ambassador, saying, quote, well, gaze upon your ambassador, other people with Tourette's.
And after only debuting Tuesday as Fanny Bryce in the Broadway musical Funny Girl, Lea Michele has tested positive for COVID-19. The Funny Girl Instagram page posted about it over the weekend. Due to Broadway protocols, Michele cannot get back onto the stage until September 20th. So while Michele has to spend her time inside, she will be replaced by Julie Benko, who will perform until September 18th. Looks like Lea Michele just had someone rain on her parade.
Dang, Kelsey. All right, Jordan and Pippen reunite. The NBA's most iconic dynamic duo may have their beef stewing at the moment, but that hasn't stopped a family affair. Larsa Pippen, ex-wife of six-time Chicago Bulls champion Scottie Pippen, was seen on a lunch date with Marcus Jordan, the son of Scottie's former teammate and five-time NBA MVP Michael Jordan. The two were spotted at a Japanese restaurant in Miami, sitting across from another couple. Larsa, who finalized her divorce from Scottie in December of last year, is still looking for love, so am I. She has spoken out on how hard it has been, but still has optimism she will find another lover. Larsa maintains that the meetup was, quote, strictly just hanging out. Let us know what you think.
Dang, feel it.
That big dang.
Leonardo DiCaprio left the internet dazed and confused when reports came out that he split with 25-year-old girlfriend Camilla Moran, sparking up old conspiracy theories. Sorry. DiCaprio has quite the roster under belt, including Blake Lively, Gisele Bündchen, and Rihanna, but all under the age of 25 years. Is there some kind of divine force stopping the Titanic actor from dating someone older than a quarter? Or maybe he likes to keep them under 25 for life insurance purposes and dependent on his taxes. A fan made a graph showing the ages of the Oscar winners' old flames when they were together, proving this theory right. If this trend continues into DiCaprio's 70s, then his eligible mate will have been born today. Let us know what you think about Hollywood's most elusive bachelor. Will he ever drop a 30 like Steph Curry, or will he stay alive at 25?
Well, in an unexpected turn of events, Queen Elizabeth passed away last Thursday. But unless you've been living under a rock, you've probably already heard the news. However, in a new turn of events, British citizens have been warned to stop leaving a very specific brand of mourning gifts that are the fault of, get this, Paddington Bear. In a skit this past June, the Queen alongside the famous bear sat for tea and proclaimed their love of marmalade sandwiches, which mourners are now leaving outside in various places. But the Royal Parks have now issued a statement urging citizens to stop leaving the beloved food out as it is turning moldy in their plastic wrappings. So instead, people who wish to pay tribute can leave more sustainable substitutes, such as flowers. Whatever happened to flowers? Like, why are people not leaving flowers?
I have no clue. Anyway. I love flowers. anyways, in case anyone forgot how Kim Kardashian and co. came into their fame, Kim's ex-boyfriend Ray J revealed shocking news that reminded everyone. 15 years ago, Kim Kardashian starred alongside her boyfriend in a rather popular adult film that helped propel her and her family into stardom just before the release of Keeping Up with the Kardashians. In the family's latest reality show, The Kardashians, the family showcased Ray J's threat to release a second tape. Kanye West, however, stole a laptop from Ray J that contained any exposing content, allowing all of Kim's assets to be contained, but Ray J wasn't done and set out to tell the truth, and apparently, it was all a lie. He claimed that he, Kim, and Kris Jenner planned the original tape's leak together, calling the leak a deal and partnership among the two groups. Neither Kim or Kris have publicly addressed the accusations.
I don't think we've seen as much tea as we've seen in this.
No, this has been like a lot.
Well, anyway, with a new season, we got a new name for one of our favorite segments. What is it? Kelsey, wrong answers only.
The Agenda.
That's such a good name. Aw. Anyway, stay tuned to find out more wrong answers when we come back.
The Agenda, Thursday nights at 9 at kentwired.com. Also check out our YouTube at youtube.com/theagendatv2.
Welcome back. I'm sure a lot of you have seen many funny TikTok trends. One recent popular one is called Wrong Answers Only.
In this edition of Blurb on the Curb, we took to the streets to see some of your wrong answers when we asked about today's pop culture. Take a look.
Welcome to Blurb on the Curb, where we randomly bother people on the street. I'm Chris.
And I'm Sydney, and we're doing wrong answers only today. So who is succeeding the Queen of England?
Harry Styles.
Ronald Reagan.
From the grave.
Is he dead? I don't know.
I don't know. What's the dean's name here?
Like the president of the school?
Yeah.
Todd Dakin.
Yeah, Todd Dakin.
I just found out, actually, from you just right now that the Queen died.
Oh, he's in breaking film. News tonight. And who's performing at the Homecoming concert this year?
Tim McGraw.
When you hear Tim McGraw. I love that song.
Beyonce.
Shakira.
Nice. Hips don't lie. Love that.
Tilly, my cat.
Madonna.
Striker, my dog.
I was supposed to be like, Tilly, never heard of her.
Young Gravy.
That's the right answer.
Wrong answer.
Big Daddy Young Gravy.
That's the right answer.
Oh, wait. She said Asmary's mom.
Downtown Cleveland, MGK opened a store. What is it?
MeganFox.com.
What do they sell at MeganFox.com? Like, what's
oh
the...
Oh, my God, for used underwear. Dollar Tree.
That makes a lot of sense.
Yeah. Lingerie shop.
That's probably possible.
M&M's. M&M's. That's
M&M's
it.
M&M's only.
Yep.
That's
okay,
only.
M&M's
only.
That makes sense.
A new restaurant.
What did he actually open? I don't even know.
Yeah, it's a coffee shop.
Okay.
I say a coffee shop, like that's not the wrong answer.
Okay.
I don't know. Magic Mike.
And Taylor Swift's new album is coming out. What is it all about?
Harry Styles.
Her new album?
Yeah. She just announced it.
Probably about sandwiches.
Sandwiches? I love a good sandwich. What's your favorite sandwich? Wrong answer.
Probably like a corn dog on a stick.
Fair enough.
We're getting some Gaylor theories happening. I don't know if you guys have heard about that.
Kind of yes.
Like seven husbands of Evelyn Hugo energy. Uh-huh. I don't know if I believe it because I think she's in love with Joe.
I really hope so.
I'm rooting.
I thought she was happy.
I saw your hands when she said Taylor Swift. It was like Swifty alert, Swifty.
I do have a Taylor Swift.
What's better than 24? 25.
Okay. This is like, I'll take it.
Finally, who's hosting the Emmys tonight?
Chris Rock.
Oh, Monty Lopez.
Monty Lopez, okay. I don't know who that is. Who's Monty?
The Addison Rae drama on TikTok. Gravy is dating Addison Rae's mom.
Oh, I knew that.
Yeah, and so Monty, which is Addison Rae's, wait, so Sherry Nicole.
Trisha Paytas' baby.
So Chris, what did you think of the Emmys last night?
Honestly, I didn't really like it that much.
Really?
Well, of course not. Wrong answers only, remember. Stay tuned because after the break, the Blurb has your Emmys recap.
That outfit slayed.
Yeah, that did slay.
That was
pants, peanut butter, a big screen television. You haven't even bought a sofa yet. A motorcycle? When your father finds out, he's gonna flip his
shoes with two buckles. What do you even need two buckles for?
Mr. Big Shot, buying whiskey shots for everybody in the bar. From the looks of it, I'd say nobody even remembers.
Feed the pig.
Gotcha! I surrender.
All right, pal. Get ready for the day, buddy.
Hey, Dad. Do we have a gun?
What's that?
Do we have a gun?
Jimmy can't sing.
And Tommy can't dance.
So we're gonna put some ants in their pants.
Aww. Kids will spend 22 minutes watching us, the super duper party troopers, singing about ants in their pants.
Isn't that funny? Ants in their pants, they've got ants in their pants, they've got ants in their pants.
Brushing for 2 minutes now can save your child from severe tooth pain later. 2 minutes, twice a day. They have the time.
It was a star-studded event at the Emmys last night, but more than that, it was a history-making night, or should I say, her story. With Kenan Thompson hosting, we were in for a night of laughs and iconic moments. So let's recap a night full of amazing memories.
All right, so firstly, the White Lotus picked up the most awards with 10 golden statues. What do you think?
That's amazing.
That's all we have for you.
No, I've never watched the show, but I've only ever heard good things, and a lot of my friends have told me to watch it, so now I definitely will, because 10 is a lot.
Yeah, that's really a lot of awards. Yeah, I've never seen it either, but if you win 10, I mean, 10. It has to be good win 10.
Yeah, exactly.
And it had a very star-studded cast, too.
Can someone explain to me what The White Lotus is about?
Yeah, I'm ashamed I don't know much about it.
I don't know.
Uh-oh, sorry, guys.
I couldn't say.
All right. Euphoria and Squid Game also both took home 6 golden statues. I'm not surprised with this. Euphoria, Squid Games definitely took over.
Yeah.
I'm not even going to say the world. I'm going to say the universe.
Yes. It was very memeable.
Yeah.
Throughout the year.
Like,
so.
I think Zendaya killed it, no matter what. Yeah, Zendaya.
The whole cast.
Kill it.
Let's
talk about Squid Games. Like, that took over last year.
Yeah. And it took a really long time for them to greenlight that show.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And the fact that it took off so fast just shows that they should have greenlit it sooner.
Yeah. It's also, isn't it the first non-English show?
Yeah, it was the first non-English show to win an Emmy. Mm-hmm. So, which is really interesting.
Yeah, it's really cool.
And then Euphoria and White Lotus both star Sydney Sweeney.
Yeah.
Oh.
So,
there you go.
Yeah, a lot of success there.
Yeah.
And then the best drama series went to Succession, and Ted Lasso and Succession were also the big winners of the night. Has anyone seen Ted Lasso?
No, but I actually
have.
So I thought Ted Lasso, fun fact, I thought Ted Lasso was like an actual person.
Oh,
so every time people were like,
okay.
I love Ted Lasso, I thought they were talking about like an actual celebrity.
And it wasn't like
but
a TV
no,
show.
No, it was not. It was Jason Sudeikis, right?
Yes.
Yeah, Jason Sudeikis.
Mm-hmm. I love the show. What do you think, Rachel?
I think it's hilarious. Mm-hmm. It does have its like funny comedy moments. And I like still need to catch up on the recent season. So
okay.
Yeah, I think what's really cool about this Emmys is that I feel like a lot of the awards and a lot of the shows actually deserved to win. I feel like it made sense. Like you weren't shocked to see Ted Lasso win. You weren't shocked to see Squid Games or Euphoria win. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
You know, it's not. I feel like last night wasn't that shocking. Yeah. I do feel like a lot of the moments, though, were very memorable. So, especially with Kenan Thompson. Yeah. Do you want to talk about that?
Yes, of course. Host Kenan Thompson opened the show with a whole song and dance. The SNL star led a troupe of dancers to remixes of theme songs from Friends, The Brady Bunch, Law and Order, Special Victims Unit, Stranger Things, and Game of Thrones.
Law and Order.
That dance was actually quite funny. I loved the whole dance sequence. It was very nice and refreshing and like a fun way to start the show. So it was really good.
And Kenan Thompson's just incredible at everything.
Mm-hmm. Exactly. He's very unproblematic.
We had a little cameo from Kel.
Yes. There's Kenan, there's Kel.
I know.
It was amazing.
You were showing me that earlier today, and that was pretty cool.
Yeah.
Whataburger, or not Whataburger.
Good burger.
So
it was a fun little spiel there. Kenan has blessed screens for the last 30 years.
Yeah.
He's good at grabbing people's attention.
Exactly.
Remember the Victorious episode he was
in? Yes.
Speaking of Victorious, Zendaya won her second Emmy for her role as Rue in Euphoria. She is the first black woman to win two Emmys in this category. She was also named Best Dressed by Bazaar for her black Valentino dress.
I think you meant she is Victorious.
Well, yes.
Yes, not the show Victorious. Yes. Because we were loud.
But it didn't, that makes sense.
I know what you're saying. Incredible.
Yeah,
absolutely.
She deserved it.
No, not only she earned it, she is such an incredible actress. I just remember the scene in Euphoria where her and her mom are yelling.
Oh, that's so real. I cried watching it.
That scene was entirely one shot.
Yeah.
So it was like amazing, it was moving, and her acting was phenomenal, along with the rest of the cast as well.
And that's from both seasons, season one and season two. This is long overdue.
That is exactly why she won her Emmy for both of them.
And that dress was gorgeous.
Yeah, of course. She's always best dressed. I don't think I've ever seen her wear something that wasn't
phenomenal. To think about Zendaya from Shake It Up to now.
Oh my gosh. What happened?
Yeah.
What happened?
Because at first, I watched her grow up.
I didn't want to watch Euphoria because I was like, oh, it's probably overrated because, you know. That always happens.
Jumping in on the bandwagon.
And then I actually started watching it and I was like, okay, I understand.
Yeah, I get it.
Yeah,
it's amazing. Sheryl Lee Ralph became the second black woman to win an Emmy for Best Supporting Actress in a Comedy Series. And her acceptance speech was beautiful. And it's just really exciting because I feel like so many black women like took home awards last night.
Yes, I know that.
Long overdue.
Yeah,
as well.
I know that Issa Rae like said that like she's just supporting everyone black.
Yeah.
in the categories, and they won pretty big over at the Emmys.
And these are top notch actresses we're talking about.
Yeah.
Like, these are people that like are just that steal the show in my opinion.
Right.
Yeah.
No matter who it is. So.
And I just recently started watching Abbott Elementary, and it's hilarious.
I need to start watching that.
It's
like,
so funny.
Just the trailer I've seen on season two.
Yeah.
And she's like, oh, it's the keys. I just die laughing. I think she's great.
It's amazing.
Well, I was not prepared to read this. It is Bad Bitch O'Clock over here. Lizzo accepts an Emmy for her competition show, Lizzo's Watch Out for Big Girls. And she shared in her speech to tell more stories referring to representation and color and sizes in media. Couldn't agree more. So proud of Lizzo.
Yeah. No, I love her.
I have gained
she's
such,
so influential.
Yeah,
like,
I have gained
so
such
many
an admiration
people.
For her, especially this year. I think, you know, it's just incredible to see what she represents and who she is. Seeing a woman like that, that's so comfortable with being themselves, and no matter who she is, no matter what the media says about her, no matter what people say about her, she's gonna do what she wants because she is that bitch.
Yeah, good. So, and I'm sorry about her clothing, the Yeti clothing.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh, it looks like the most comfortable workout clothes ever. Like, I want to buy it.
It's just so exciting to see like a woman like that have a platform now that we can listen to and young girls can look up to. And it's so exciting.
I'm just glad we're getting to a place of not only acceptance, but equity.
Yes.
You know? Yeah. And I think that's what's super important. Equality and equity.
Yeah, exactly.
It definitely is.
So the Emmys are always fun, but they were kind of boring this year because we like expected everybody who won because it was all well deserved. But always a fun night, always good. Mm-hmm. Loved it.
And you know, it's a fun little twist. There's no slaps or anything.
Yeah, exactly.
And I think everyone, and we've already said this, and this is the last thing, but everyone deserved and had earned all of those awards. Yes. And I think it was a big night. No matter, it was all about representation. I think that's what's super important.
Yes, exactly.
But don't go anywhere, because up next, we are going to hear all about the dazzling Harry Styles dance party from this last weekend.
Well, Thomas, you've got pre-diabetes. But with more exercise and a change in diet, it can be reversed.
I've tried exercising. It just makes me hungry for bacon.
I love bacon, too. And who really likes to exercise?
Not me.
Me neither.
Nobody. So we're good?
What? Oh, you still have pre-diabetes. Big time.
Not completing high school is more of a social thing than it was an academic thing. Even though all these years have passed, I still had that longing to have my diploma. I have a mentor, and she convinced me to continue my education.
No one receives a diploma alone.
If you're even considering getting your high school diploma, go get it. You can do it.
Find free adult education classes near you at finishyourdiploma.org.
Over this past weekend, the Flash Activities Board hosted Kent's very own Harry Styles-themed dance party. Filled with themed cookies, cardboard cutouts, and boa feathers galore, it was truly a night to remember. Let's check out some of that footage that the Burb captured.
I'm Hayden Cruz.
I'm Anne-Marie Carabinas.
And I'm Alex Thompson.
And we're here live at Harry Styles Night, sponsored by Fab for the Blurb.
The night began with everyone entering the Kent State Ballroom in their Harry Styles best to win prizes in a door raffle.
So you are actually one of the people, if not the sole person, that came up with the idea for this. How did you like go about planning for this event?
Yes, so I am the new director of entertainment, so it was a role that was created this summer-ish, and they kind of wanted me to do something with it. So I was like, I party, which is a very big thing, and I was like, let's get on that. So I knew that Harry was huge, and especially since he has movies coming out real soon, and he was just a very well-known name with tour and everything like that. So I was like, let's get on it, and here we are. So we're having a Harry night, looks great out there, and yeah, it's exciting.
This outfit is absolutely incredible. So what's the inspo for it? You gotta tell us.
Okay, so my inspo actually came from Pinterest. I typed in Love on Tour outfit inspo, and I just went in my closet and found what I felt fitted.
Awesome, thank you.
Of course, thank you.
What is your favorite Harry song?
Mine is Meet Me in the Hallway.
Okay.
Mine is She.
Okay, good choices, good choices.
The night also included bracelet making with beads themed around the three Harry Styles solo albums, as well as a photo booth with two Harry Styles cutouts and pictures inspired by Harry Styles, plus cookies themed to all things Harry Styles.
Just let me adore you.
Well, that is going to do it for us tonight at Harry Styles Night, sponsored by Fab. Once again, I'm Hayden Cruz.
I'm Alex Thompson.
I'm Anne-Marie Carabinas.
And I'm Harry.
Thank you so much for joining us, and enjoy the rest of your night.
I don't know about you, Anne-Marie, but I genuinely think that was probably one of my most memorable days here at Kent State so far.
This semester, yeah. It was so much fun. Seeing like all of the people dressed up in their hairy best.
Yes. As someone that is unfortunately not going to any Love on Tour shows soon, it definitely felt like the same environment that some of Harry's shows have, especially with the boa feathers on the floor.
Oh my gosh.
PSA, let's start putting hairspray on those, be a little more environmentally friendly. But it was amazing. I started the conga line. That was very exciting.
There was two conga lines. One to treat people with kindness, which you saw, and there was another one to, as it was, I think, and I was aggressively texting you. I'm like, oh my god, there's a conga line!
And the prizes that they had were insane.
Yeah.
They had a budget for the prizes, for sure. And for some more music updates, up next we have some of our cast members discussing Lea Michele as her new role as Fanny Bryce in Broadway's Funny Girl.
So, I just moved in with his family, and it's embarrassing. The little one, he likes to go outside and crawl around in the giant litter box. I don't know what he's doing. I mean, I was born and I knew how to use the litter box. Look at that. That's disgusting. Oh, poop already. You're making me nervous. Oh, okay, I can't look at this anymore. I really hope he grows out of this, for his sake.
We'd do anything for kids. Yet 1 in 6 children in the U.S. struggle with hunger. Help end childhood hunger near you. Learn how at feedingamerica.org.
Welcome back. On September 6th, Lea Michele made her Funny Girl Broadway debut as the lead character, Fanny Bryce. This was just announced in July after Beanie Feldstein disclosed that she would be departing from the show. Now Michele is playing a Fanny Gleek's dream casting, or did we think her association with Miss Bryce should have ended with Glee?
All right, so just quick question. We all saw the TikTok of Lea Michele singing Don't Rain on My Parade, correct?
Yes.
What do we think of it? Because here's the thing, I'm upset that she did so well. Like, because her character is such, like, a Fanny Bryce fan, it was like, I was like just expecting her to like whip it like out, like just all that talent. It was like kind of frustrating to see, but it was still good nonetheless.
No, she's insane. To actually quote Glee, she may be difficult, but boy, can she sing.
No, like, literally, she's insane. Exactly.
I mean, I was about to say, it's like, I mean, she was on the Glee for a reason because of, like, you know, how good she could sing. I mean, a lot of those cast members were on the show for a reason. And I mean, I think her talent's really shown.
It really has. Like, it's insane. So when she was involved on Glee, her character, you know, was obsessed with Funny Girl and playing Fanny Bryce on Broadway, and even ended up getting the role of Fanny Bryce later on the show. Do we think that this background is a reason why she possibly got the role?
Oh, for sure. I'm pretty sure, like, even before, like, this production of Funny Girl, they were thinking of one earlier that kind of ended up getting scrapped, and she was already in the talks of that because of that, her character on Glee.
Really? I didn't know that. I'm not surprised, though. Like,
yeah. It seems like even though she's, like, really difficult to work with, she keeps getting, like, really good opportunities,
Yeah.
which
is kind of discouraging, but also, like, man, she can sing. I saw some reviews of her opening night, and it said that it sounded like she was just, like, practicing and singing that song in the shower for, like, years, and it genuinely, like, seems like she's living her absolute dream.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure, like, when she first, like debuted, she got, like, a standing ovation with every single song that she sang. Mm-hmm. And I was like, yeah, like, I'm pretty sure. And that, like, was just insane to me. Couldn't even believe it.
She's a talented girl.
Yeah, she really is.
No, I think it was definitely stunt casting, but it worked.
It really does work.
Because when the musical first debuted, it wasn't doing that well, like, financially, with ticket sales, but, I mean, when Leah started...
No, I mean, I'm not gonna lie, when I found out that Leah Michelle was gonna be Fanny Bryce, I was like, oh my god, like, of course, I'm stuck in Ohio, but I would love to go to New York and see her, because that's who she played on Glee, that's what her character got. But anyways, Leah Michelle actually replaced Beanie Feldstein on Funny Girl, and they ended up changing the final dress. Do we think that this is because of a body issue or just a creative decision?
Personally, for me, I think it could be both. Mm-hmm. I think maybe Leah opted to do a more revealing one herself because that's what she felt comfortable in, possibly. Mm-hmm. But I'm not entirely sure. In reality, it's very apparent that her wearing something that has more revealing arms and more freeing, it seems like it might have been a decision of the crew too, because I mean, when people are overweight, they tend to try to cover up the character or the actor, and that's really sad.
Yeah, no, I totally understand that. Especially, I mean, they both look amazing in the dress.
They did. They both
It just is a little upsetting to, see the fact that, Beanie Feldstein had to wear, sleeves. Because it's, it doesn't matter. She'll look good no matter what, you know what I mean? And I don't know if maybe, even Beanie Feldstein just maybe felt comfortable with sleeves.
That's
true. You know, who knows? But, no matter what, they both look great in the dress.
Yeah.
But, do you guys have any...
I think even if the actresses made the conscious decision separately on their own terms, there's still bigger nuances at play here that it's really hard to ignore, especially in this world where we're coming to realize that certain things aren't okay and that representation matters. And it's just it's kind of upsetting that they kind of just brushed it off as nothing.
Hmm. Yes.
Yeah.
I totally agree on that.
But Jane Lynch, aka Sue Sylvester, from Glee, was also on Funny Girl. But as soon as it was announced that Leah was coming to Broadway, she left. So show execs say that it was just a coincidence, but do we think that it was? Or did she just not want to work with Leah, I guess?
I mean, it's hard to say. Leah has been known to be a little difficult to work with, you know? So I wouldn't be surprised if she heard the news and decided to get out of there as fast as possible.
Yeah,
that would be nice. Just like in that episode where she left halfway through the musical.
Halfway through the musical, because she was like, this is awful.
Yeah. I mean, I like to give her the benefit of the doubt, you know?
Yeah.
That's fair.
Here's the thing, no matter what, Jane Lynch, she can do whatever she wants.
Iconic.
I love Jane Lynch. You know, she's just iconic.
Yes.
Also, you're dressed as Mr. Schuster.
Of course.
Sylvester's enemy. So, do you have any other comments on this?
You know,
Will Schuster vibes, you know?
Will Schuster vibes. I think, as Will Schuster once said in his Gold Digger song, she's a gold digger. You know?
Oh, okay. Boy. That was one of the worst performances you could pull from.
Should I? I know some Mr. Schuster things, but honestly, I'm not that big of a Mr. Schuster fan, but I like
you shouldn't be.
Yeah.
But know what though? I like his style. He has a really obviously I think his fashion style's the best.
Yeah.
Sure.
That's a matter of opinion.
Anyways, final thoughts, everyone.
I think that From like a money-making standpoint, it was really smart of them to cast Leo.
Yeah, it really was. I don't know. The thing is, like, no matter what, she's gonna do well. No matter, you know, like, it's like, bound to happen. But
yeah, Leo has that Broadway experience already under her belt, so she's already up there knowing what she's doing. So I think it's just to see what the future holds is what I'm really interested in.
Yeah, personally. It was a smart choice.
Well, you might want to stick around because we're going to be discussing everything that happened at the D23 Expo.
Good morning. Hope you all had a good weekend and are ready to be inspired. One quick thing I want to remind you guys to be studying.
Major key alert. Did you just look at your phone while you was in class? You played yourself.
Class, today we're talking about inspirational quotes.
You want to get that paper? You better turn in that paper and get an A+. That's a major key. Another one.
Mogul talk. You want to reach the mountaintop? You got to go hard. To succeed, you have to believe. Stay focused. Fly higher than the eagle. Don't ever play yourself. The key is to make it, so make it.
Louise, can you give me an example of an inspirational quote from recent history?
Don't play yourself. The key is to make it.
And who said that?
I did. Now that's a major key alert.
Learn the real major keys to getting to college at GetSchool.com.
Disney kicked off their century celebration with the D23 Expo in California over the weekend.
All right, I guess first things first, we're going to be discussing The Little Mermaid. At the D23 Expo, they showed a teaser trailer for The Little Mermaid live action starring the one and only Halle Bailey. I don't know about you guys, but this is going to be the final reason why I decide to learn how to swim.
You don't know how to swim.
I don't know That's how to good. Swim. I'm a Pisces and I don't know how to swim, but after seeing Halle Berry sing Part of Your World, I will learn how to swim.
Okay. Right.
I have
so,
to.
Can I just say, I am a Chloe and Halle stan, one of their finals, Ungodly Hours, on my wall right now. And I was so ecstatic to hear that Halle Bailey was playing Ariel a couple years ago.
Yes.
So sure. Deserved. So fitting.
Yes.
I truly believe it's fitting.
And the Chloe and Halle fan base, all of their fans are called Sirens. And on their debut album, The Kids Are All Right, they did a photo shoot and Halle was wearing a blanket that was a blue mermaid tail.
That's
really how Sue sees it. Right there.
And her voice sounded amazing. In
yeah,
the
for sure.
Let's talk about the trailer.
For
I want to
sure.
say,
haunting.
When I first way. When I first saw it, I just was, it, to me, I was stunned. Like, I think yes. seeing Halle as Ariel, it just gives me chills. It really just gave me chills.
Yeah.
It's just such a, she's just so beautiful, and I really believe, and her voice fit it so well. At the end, when she started singing Part of Your World, what'd you guys think about that?
She blew it out of the water.
Whoa, Rachie.
And seeing people's reactions to her was amazing, and it's very nice that you know, see someone that kind of looks like me on screen, and I know we don't get that much representation. So.
Yeah,
for
really
sure,
nice.
I completely agree.
Like I said previously, it's all about representation and equity,
mm-hmm.
and I think that's what's super important about this mm-hmm. role. Like, Halle is that bitch, so leave her alone.
Oh my,
she is though.
Oh my,
she is
exactly.
that
girl.
Yes, and I'm so excited to see The Little Mermaid.
Exactly.
That's all I can say.
Yes. Just excitement. But we did get a teaser also for Disenchanted, actually the full trailer.
Yeah.
Yes.
And I am just really excited to see Amy Adams and Patrick Dempsey back together. What do you guys think?
Me too. Yes. So I actually just watched Enchanted. I did not watch Enchanted the first time. Don't get it twisted. I watched Enchanted when it came out 15 years ago in theaters. Oh my God, such a good movie. But I realized it was on Disney Plus on Saturday, since past Saturday, and I rewatched it, and I actually
That's
watched
so
it twice.
Exciting.
watched it on Saturday and Sunday.
And it's amazing to like see them seamlessly step back into those roles again.
Yes, it
so,
is.
And I love the twist.
What do we think about that plot twist? So Giselle is gonna, it seems, this is what it seems, is that yes. Giselle wished for a fairy tale life. Mm-hmm. And that kind of meant because she's a stepmom, she becomes
the evil stepmom
yes. of like Cinderella, stuff like that, that we typically see in Disney movies. What do we think?
I think this is a really unique take on a sort of fairy tale. Yeah. And I'm very excited to see it.
Yeah, it's gonna be very interesting. And I loved how easily that she's like flipping back and forth from being bad to like really good and like, oh no. So like, I thought it was very cute, and I will definitely be seeing it on Thanksgiving Day post Thanksgiving dinner. So
right
after you head to the theater. Yeah.
Here's the thing, it's on Disney Plus though.
Yeah,
it's
not
a theater.
So it'll be easy to watch it in the living room.
After you're done eating, to go sit down with the family.
Now that's,
I'll eat my Thanksgiving pie.
I have Disney Plus, so I'm okay. But for all of you, get Disney Plus. Oh, sorry, not supposed to sponsor, but it's okay. Canceled.
So another thing that was announced was Inside Out 2. And I personally am very excited for it because the first one, it was like, it was a mixture of deep, funny, sad, inspiring. It was literally everything you could wish for in a movie. And to see that it's getting a sequel is like, it's making me like excited, but also nervous because I know I'm probably gonna cry.
That was the first Disney movie that I've ever cried to. And I like to think that I don't cry to movies. You know, I go in there, I'm all like tough guy. No, I was straight, it was straight tears. It was no good.
Men have emotions too.
Yes.
I'm really excited to see, because I believe they're introducing new emotions, are they not?
I think they are.
I think so. I'm very interested to see, since she's going to be a teenager in this new movie, what those emotions are going to be.
Oh boy.
There's been a lot of interesting speculation.
I didn't think this through. Okay.
Oh my.
It's going to be very interesting to see what route they take with that.
So many more islands in her brain are going to pop up.
Yeah. I'm
R.I.P. Bing Bong.
No, I was about to say that. No, Inside Out, low-key, like top five saddest movies.
That destroyed
of Disney.
Me.
I'm sorry,
that
but
and
Bing,
Coco.
We so I was in, okay, kind of story time, but I was in AP Psych in high school, and we watched Inside Out because it represents a lot of what you learn in psychology. And oh my God, 18-year-old Shane was bawling his damn eyes out when Bing Bong passed away or disappeared. Sorry, I guess kids.
Oh yeah, he sort of like evaporated.
He evaporated. Why am I about to be here right now? Like, that was so sad. So I'm really nervous to see, oh my God, is Bing Bong gonna come back?
But the thing is, like, since she's a teenager, will she have, because Bing Bong was supposed to be a stuffed animal, was he
not?
So I still have stuffed animals.
Oh my God.
But are they going to have a new sort of stuffed animal, or is it gonna be something else?
No, I think it's gonna be Bing Bong. Spoiler alert, I have the script. this is what's gonna happen. Bing Bong's gonna come back because she's gonna go through something. And then like all of her trauma in her teenage years.
Like regression? Like,
yes, and then she's gonna see Bing Bong and it's gonna heal. It's about
healing her inner child.
Yes.
I think Shane was working as a producer on the film.
Hire me, Disney, or am I already hired?
You see his name in the credits right there.
Jalen, what do you got for us?
Man, one of my favorite personal book series is getting a new adaptation in Percy Jackson.
Oh, never seen. My God.
Now, the version with Dylan O'Brien was personally.
Dylan O'Brien?
Logan Lerman.
That's
right. Ooh. Logan Lerman. One of my favorites.
So for me, like, it was okay because, like, if it was a standalone, I would have liked it. But I was, like, a huge book nerd with Percy Jackson growing up. I even, like, have a whole, like, web series of Harry Potter x Percy Jackson via YouTube and TikTok. Like, I made original characters and everything. I'm that nerdy. I love it so much. But, like, also it wasn't really book accurate.
Yeah.
So I'm glad that we're going to
We're very excited for this new adaptation, and I can't wait to see it. But unfortunately, that is all the time we have for this episode of The Blurb. Be sure to check out our social media and YouTube channel, and to check in next Tuesday for all of the celebrity tea. And have a safe night, everyone. Bye.
Bye.
My heart doesn't see race. Love is love.